Hi everybody, Gordon here. The topic for today's video will be me going into a bit of details as to one of Linus's videos which he released not too long ago. How one of his bunch of Torinators, his file servers, had ran into issues with failed drives and all that.
That resulted in us permanently losing data that we don't have any backup for.
I believe there were 3 points in the video especially where we can pick up some lessons on. So I'll get right into it. So we'll start off with the first point. Let's roll the tape.
So we've always had substantially lower need for tech support than the average company. And as a result, we have never hired a full-time IT person. What we all have in common is that we have other jobs to do, meaning that it's never really been clear who exactly is supposed to be accountable when something slips through the cracks.
To further elaborate on what Linus said, it is never a good idea to have your staff doing double duty in both their usual job scope as well as maintaining the IT infrastructure, especially when your infrastructure is as complicated and comprehensive as what he has. Now, in our view, and in my opinion, what I would say is that the point at which you should consider either A, getting an IT professional in-house, or outsourcing your IT maintenance to a full-time professional would probably be either A, when you have a headcount of 5, a boss as well as a couple of staff, accountants, that kind of thing, or you have other things other than a couple of laptops, desktop, maybe like NAS or a network attached drive, a server in-house, that kind of thing. So this is one point that I would say, yeah, you should really be getting somebody to look after it. Of course, when it gets to that point, you're gonna end up with what happened with Linus, that the server was getting problems, but because the 3 of them were too busy doing their usual things, none of them realized it until, well, it was too late. Now onto point number 2.
In our case, these errors probably cropped up due to a sudden power loss or due to naturally occurring bit rot, as they were never configured to shut down nicely while on backup power in the case of an outage, and we've had quite a few of those over the years.
To interject into this, especially when you're deploying servers like this, you would have what is known as a UPS or uninterruptible power supply. Now, I do not know whether Linus and team actually had a UPS deployed, or they didn't have one, or they had one and it was not configured properly, but usually if you have a UPS and it was deployed properly, the UPS is connected to via USB cable to the servers or servers. The sequence of event usually happens like this. The UPS will detect a power failure. It will send a signal via that USB cable to the server to initiate a shutdown. So it's like, hey, there's a power cut, initiates shutdown procedure. And then in the case of, let's say, Windows OS, the server starts shutting down. They at least get things powered down and all that properly. Now, what happens when you suddenly cut power instead of having a proper shutdown? Several things can happen of with damage to the hardware, that kind of thing. This is possible. Again, I do not know whether they actually had a UPS in place, but this is one lesson that I feel that can be expanded upon here. To explain what a UPS or uninterruptible power supply, let's say for example, you have the UPS connected to your mains, and then from the UPS, it's connected to the AC in of, let's say, your computer or your server or whatever machine it is. So what this does is that in the event of a power cut or power failure, the job of the UPS is twofold. One is to supply enough power to the affected machine for, give an example, maybe 5 to 10 minutes. Why 5 to 10 minutes? Because this 5 to 10 minutes gives enough time for the UPS to send a signal to the affected machine to tell him, hey, there's a power cut. Initiate shutdown procedure. So then the machine on this end, okay, I'm gonna perform a shutdown. It will just shut down right there and then. That's the primary reason of uninterruptible power supply or UPS, at least for consumer level models. Now we come to point 3, which is the one that I want to highlight the most because it is the most important. First and foremost, redundancy is not equals to backup. Linus and gang, as they mentioned, they learned this the hard way. The moment they had too many of their drives fail or go down, they had data that simply could not be recovered.
And unfortunately, much further along in the process, the same thing happened on Delta 1. That means that both the original and new petabyte projects, old and new Vault, have suffered non-recoverable data loss. So now what do we do?
And because they had all these Torinators, I believe they had like 3 or 4 of them, none of them, I think, was designated as maybe like a local backup target, that kind of thing. When their RAID array failed, that was it. Or, you know, to put it quite plainly, simply, don't put everything in one basket. A good strategy is to have both redundancy, your RAID arrays, plus a backup. Say for example, you have like your main server. Let's say I take a 2-bay NAS for example. You have it in RAID 1, mirroring. So in case one drive fails, the other one has a copy. But your data is secured if you have only one drive fail. But what happens if you have both drives in the 2-bay NAS fail? This is where having the backup here comes in handy. If there's one lesson that we can learn in the world, especially in the last couple of years, shit happens. So redundancy and a backup, preferably, they come hand in hand. You should have both. So to sum the whole things up, these are, I feel, are the three lessons and the three pointers that we can learn from what happened to Linus and gang. If you like content like this, yeah, hit the subscribe button right below. And until then, adidoo!